Hello friends, in this video I wanted to show you guys about the new design which I made. This design is particularly designed for UAE market, and this 3G module is the same one which is used in my VALTRACK-V3 design. In the VALTRACK-V3 was designed for being a falling alarm, and we had used a SIM5320E module along with a SIM39E GPS tracker in it. And this design is a variation of that design. And the major highlight of the design is the addition of the Bluetooth module. This is the Bluetooth 4.0 module, which is very useful in configuring the parameters of the device. Because this module will open up a Bluetooth 4 transparent UART connection as soon as it's powered on. And the microcontroller can directly send the data on the UART port, and that data will be received on the Android application. And on the other side, the Android application, whatever it pushes the data onto the device, the data will be available on the microcontroller UART port. So we don't need to configure any of the parameters of the Bluetooth module. It's directly loaded with that firmware, and it's quite useful because it will reduce a lot of software to be written to configure the Bluetooth module. And to tell about the power supply of the device, the power supply is designed to take in up to 28 volts because of the switching regulator used. This switching regulator has been compatible with one more regulator in the same family, which can go up to 48 volts or 60 volts also. And we have added a diode for reverse voltage protection. So even if you connect the battery voltage in reverse, the device will not be damaged because the diode would be reverse biased and it will not allow any current flow. And on this side of the board, this part is the battery switching regulator or the battery charger. And this is used to charge the internal battery, which will be connected to these two pins. So the device will have a battery backup if the power supply is removed from the device. So if the 12 volt connection of the vehicle battery is removed, the device will automatically switch to the internal battery. The small button provided here is the button which can be used to enter the configuration mode for the Bluetooth, and we can also configure this button to enter into debug mode, and it will print out whatever the transaction is happening between the GSM module and the microcontroller. The one more thing we added in this is the measurement of the fuel gauge. So we have just added a voltage divider circuit for it, which can be used to measure the voltage variations happening on the fuel gauge. So we still need to tune the impedance matching and all those things. And as you can see here, this device is made for vehicle tracking purposes only. That's why these two external antennas. The SIM5320E module is equipped with the GPS module inside, and it can give the GPS data directly to the microcontroller using data commands. And this is the GPS antenna, and this is the GSM antenna connection. There are some components added which can be used to tune the GPS antenna parameters. And on the bottom side of the board, we have added a nano SIM push-push type connector. So you push in to insert the SIM card, and you push it again to remove the SIM card. And the accelerometer added is a 16-bit accelerometer, and it can give data that is of a very high resolution, and you can easily use it for vibration sensing. So the another application of this board was to measure the vibrations that are happening in the vehicle environment, and that's why we added this accelerometer. This because this accelerometer spec said that it is suitable for vibration sensing, and because of the 16-bit resolution, it can give very good data for performing the calculations or the measurements. The EEPROM is the same from the earlier designs. It's the 1 megabit EEPROM. It can be used to store the configuration parameters, or if you want, you can store or log the GPS location data also. And this is the power MOSFET. This is the single MOSFET present on this device. It can be used to control the power to the SIM5320E module. The good thing about the SIM5320 module is that it is a 3G module, and it is having the UMTS band support for different regions in the same footprint. It is available in SIM5320E, SIM5320A, and SIM5320J combinations. The SIM5320E is for European frequency bands, and SIM5320A is for American frequency bands, and SIM5320J supports some of the Australian 3G networks like Telstra. The microcontroller used is the same STM32L0 microcontroller. This is an ultra low power microcontroller from ST Microelectronics, and it is having footprint compatible successors in the Cortex M4 band also. So if we want to switch to a higher memory footprint, then we can easily do it by just replacing the part, and all the pins will be compatible. We also added a couple of digital inputs and analog inputs. One more application of the board was to measure the fuel level of the vehicle. And this board will only support the resistive fuel gauge type devices, and it will directly measure the fuel gauge value, which is just a resistance from 0 to 200 ohms. And it can be measured using the analog voltage that is coming onto the microcontroller input. So that's all is there in this board now. The boards are looking quite good, and we are able to get most of the parts working. Bluetooth was the same one which you used in my OBD GPS tracker, and it's working fine. So there is not much configuration to be done in this device. So then the SIM5320 part of the hardware software was also done, and the device is working fine. We still need to work on the fuel gauge reading, and once it's done, I will make a demo video of it and update you guys. So that's all for now. If you like this video, hit the like button, share with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more such content. Thank you for watching.